everyone, it's Kayla, and today I'm doing my Christmas book haul for you all. And yeah, it's early this year because I've decided to use my Amazon gift cards towards a desk chair instead of buying more books because, let's be honest, I don't need them. So everything that I got for Christmas is already done, so I can show you. So first up, I wanted to show you this. I bought it on Black Friday. It's the only thing I bought. It is the Wings of Fire box set, books 1 through 5. Wings of Fire is by 2T Sutherland. I'm really sorry if I pronounced that wrong. Basically, I think this series is about dragons and war between dragon tribes, and it's a middle grade series. However, my friend Connor has warned me that there's a lot of violence in it, and he thinks that if it was about humans and had this much violence, it would not be middle grade. But I'm super excited. Dragons, guys. Dragons. And I used the bookish coupon on Amazon, the 30% off a bookish item, to get this, so I thought, yes, let's do it. So then the Wolfpack did a name exchange, and Lainey from Ginger Reads Lainey had me, and she got me the second book in the Dark Fever series by Cara Marie Monning, and this is Blood Fever, and she got it for me because she wants me to read it. She wants me to read the series, obviously. So now that I have two books in the series, I really want to marathon it. I've heard great things. It's urban fantasy, and yeah, it's all the rage right now. Lainey also got me Dream Strider by Lindsay Smith, and this book is like an Inception-based story. I don't know if you ever saw the movie Inception with Leo DiCaprio. Oh, my love. She is a trained Dream Strider. She enters the dream world, and through it, she slips into a sleeping person's body and dons their skin as her own, which I think is fantastic. Lainey sent it to me because she hopes that we can buddy read it together. We have been terrible at buddy reading things together. We always start something and then never finish it. And yeah, so hopefully we can buddy read this one for sure. Thank you so much, Lainey. You are the bestest every single year. So then my friend Lindsay from Lindsay Ray sent me a present. She sent me the Magician's Trilogy box set by Lev Grossman. It is a beautiful, beautiful box set. And normally I throw away the box sets and keep the books, but this is actually pretty nice. I love it. Love the patterns. The patterns are the same on the spines. And yeah, I am so excited about this. I've been wanting to read The Magicians forever, and now I finally can. And I know Sam just got this for Christmas, Sam from Thoughts on Tomes, so I'm sure we can read it together. And I've heard that it is a fantasy that people kind of love to hate. Everyone knows I love fantasy, so I'm really excited that I got this. Thank you so much, Lindsay. So then Connor and I exchanged, and he got me this omnibus of His Dark Materials by Philip Pullman. And I originally read this series back when The Golden Compass came out in the movies, and I marathoned the series and I loved it. It's such a fantastic adventure, middle grade, and now I have it in this form. I lost the paperbacks over time because pre-book two, I didn't give a shit about what happened to my books, and I lent them out and things like that. I'm sure some of you can relate to that, but anyways, now I have it in my collection. So yes, thank you, Connor. I am very excited, and I don't think Connor has read this, so hopefully it'll be a buddy read. I love buddy reading with Connor. It is the best. Randomly, my mom got me a pack of Game of Thrones playing cards, and I think it's fantastic. Oh no, they all fell on the floor. And just to let you know, every card says you win or you die. Perfection. So then I also got some Funko Pops. I got Rumpelstiltskin from Once Upon a Time, and he's just so great. He even sparkles. I don't know if you can see it, but he does. Yeah, there it is, see? It even has Rumpelstiltskin written on this little teeny tiny dagger. So yeah, I think that's awesome. Along with Rumpel, I got Regina, the Evil Queen from Once Upon a Time. She is perfect. My dad got me Heisenberg from Breaking Bad. He's even holding a little crystal meth bottle, which I think is awesome. And then on the Disney side of things, I got Tiana from Princess and the Frog. And with her came this little teeny tiny Naveen to go with her. It's so cute. I can't take it. And I got Mushu from Mulan. Mulan is one of my favorite Disney movies ever. One of my favorite movies ever. And I just love it so much. And just like Tiana had Naveen, he has Cricket. Look at Cricket. It's just so precious. I can't take it. I also got The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up, The Japanese Art of Decluttering and Organizing by Marie Kondo. I feel like this book is just going to be like a philosophy of getting rid of things that you don't need. Why are you going to keep those buttons over there, etc., etc.? I have a lot of crap, And maybe this will get me thinking the right way about what I really need in my life and what I don't. These books are in no particular order, so I'm just jumping ship from that book, nonfiction, to Their Fractured Life by Amy Kaufman and Megan Spooner. And this is the third and final book in the companion series of These Broken Stars. And I'm just so excited. And I saw this cover online, like when they released it, obviously. But in person, guys, it is just amazing. Like the colors and everything, like I can't do it justice. It is just so beautiful. And yes, I know I say that a lot about covers, but this one is legit. Like, look at this. It looks like lightning, but it's her dress. And I just, it's fantastic. It's fantastic. I also got Shades of Grey by Jasper Ford. I've been wanting to pick this up for about 2 years now, ever since I heard Priscilla at the Readables talk about it. And now Connor from Connor O'Brien has talked about it. So I desperately, desperately want to get to it soon. It's an adult dystopian, and the society is set up based on what colors you see, what colors you perceive, and how many shades of that color you can see, which I find really fascinating and really different. So I'm really anxious to check it out. I also got The Ice Dragon by George R. Martin. This is a children's story set in the Song of Ice and Fire universe. And yeah, I know that sounds like an oxymoron. My cousin pointed that out to me. But hey, I wanted it and I received it, and it has beautiful illustrations in it. Along with The Ice Dragon, I got a Game of Thrones graphic novel, Volume 4. This actually completes the entire adaptation now of A Game of Thrones, the first book in the series. So all four volumes cover the first book. And leafing through it, I've leafed through the other ones. I wanted to wait to get this one to read them all together at once, like the book. I noticed that I'm not sure about the art. However, based on what I'm seeing, it's a more faithful adaptation than the show. So they went by the books and not the show, which I really, really appreciate. So I can't wait to marathon these, and I will definitely, definitely be doing that in 2016. So then I also got 10,000 Skies Above You by Claudia Gray. This is the second book in the Firebird trilogy. I read A Thousand Pieces of You back in January or February, and I absolutely loved it. It's about parallel universes and a girl on a quest to find out the mystery behind her father's death, and I really, really love it. The realms that she goes to are so creative, and that's the Eiffel Tower. I'm just saying, I love France and I really want to go someday, so I'm excited. Maybe I'll get to go in this book. So then I also got this awesome book on how to draw fantasy art and RPG maps. I had put this on my wish list after seeing it on Amazon because I really want to make an awesome fantasy map for the story that I'm writing, and I'm pleasantly blown away by what I see in this book so far. Like, it is a nicely put together, colorful instruction how-to guide, and I cannot wait to like read it and just be fascinated. And yeah, I want to get to this soon. I now am the proud owner of Lost Ocean by Joanna Bassford. I now have all three books: Secret Garden, Enchanted Forest, and now Lost Ocean. It's just so beautiful. I don't even want to color in it. Like, guys, seriously, it is just gorgeous. Like, all the seascapes in here are just incredible. I can't even tell you. I'm looking at it right now, like, oh, so pretty. Love these coloring books. Highly recommend them. I mean, they're the best out there. Joanna Bassford is amazing. She actually has a YouTube channel, which I didn't know until like a month ago, so I'll leave that link below. So then I got another coloring book, not Joanna Bassford, but the Game of Thrones coloring book. I'm just so excited. When I opened it up, I was like, oh my god! Ooh, it's the Targaryen crest. I love this page. It's so pretty. My grandmother got this for me. She picked up a bunch of Five Below and handed them out to all my family. So if you're not sure if you're gonna be into the coloring book craze, I recommend checking out the selection at Five Below. They're really cheap. I think this one was $5. And it's one-sided perforated pages, which you can use markers and everything, and they won't bleed or anything like that. While we're on the subject of coloring books, I also got the Staedtler color pencils, the Ergo Soft color pencils. These are like legit, guys. Like, I cannot believe this is like the Sephora of color pencils. So I'm really excited that I got these for shading and everything. And then I also got a pack of the Staedtler Tri Plus Fine Liner, and they are marker pens that you color with, and I've heard great things. I've also heard that they bleed though sometimes, so I guess it depends how much pressure you put on, but these colors look amazing, and I'm just so happy to have this brand. Like, you have no idea. Yeah, I was so excited to open these. So then I got The Wicked and the Divine, Volume 2, Fandemonium. I've heard mixed things about this series, but it's Sam from Thoughts on Tome's favorite comic series, so I'm really anxious to get to it, and the art is literally so beautiful. So I know I'm gonna like it at least that much. My boyfriend got me Miss Marvel Volume 1, No Normal. This is one of my first Marvel comics, and I was so excited to get this because I haven't read a lot of superhero comics lately. It's also kind of really exciting because it's the first bookish item my boyfriend has gotten me, so you know, props to him. Clap, clap, clap. But yes, this is what the art looks like. So then my sister got me The Complete Mouse. I think that's how you say it. I'm not sure. Mouse. Mouse. And it's a graphic novel. There's normally two parts, but this contains all of them. And this is what the art style looks like. So based on the art style, I wasn't sure if I would have picked this up on my own because I wasn't sure if I could get used to the art style. This is a retelling of World War II, except that the Jews are mice and the Nazis are cats, and I find that extremely fascinating. It's well renowned, like there's a lot of awards for this, and a lot of people have to read it in college and high school and things like that. My sister also got me the second Once Upon a Time graphic novel. This is produced by Marvel, and this one's called Out of the Past. Do you see my husband hooked there? He's looking hella fine. Just saying. So the last two things I have to show you, I am just so excited to own. And the first being the first three books of Why the Last Man. These three contain the first six volumes of the series. There's 10 volumes in all. And they've been coming out in paperback, the deluxe editions. So I have the first three now. I think book four comes out in paperback in February, I believe. My dad got these for me, and I already read the first book. Amazing, 5 stars. And it's by Brian K. Vaughan, and he's the author of Saga, and illustrated by Pia Guerra and Jose Marzan Jr. I'm so sorry if I pronounced those wrong, but I'm loving this series so much. The way it's told and the storytelling is just fantastic. It's kind of like back and forth between characters, and I just love it so much. And there's a blurb on the front cover, the best graphic novel I've ever read, Stephen King. And I find it ironic because it kind of reminds me of The Stand in a way. For those of you that don't know, The Stand by Stephen King, it's a disease that wipes out about 99% of the population. This series is about something happens, I'm not sure what yet, and it wipes out everything with a Y chromosome, all the male population, all the animals that are males, everything with a Y chromosome just dies suddenly. The females are left to figure out what the hell's going on and live and prosper and everything, except one man survives, his name's Yorick, and his pet monkey survives too, and they're both males, they're the last two males on Earth, and that's just pretty much the premise of this series, and I'm just loving it so, so much. My mom got me the complete hardback box set edition of The Mortal Instruments with the original covers because I own the Infernal Devices in hardback like this, and I just wanted all my spines to match because, guys, the Shadowhunter world, despite the hate that it gets, will always hold a special place in my heart, and I just so excited to own this in physical copy. I've never owned all of the books in the series in physical copy, and I'm just so happy. And this is really heavy, so I'm gonna put it down, okay? Okay. Whew. So shiny and pretty, and I'm just feeling all the nostalgic feels, and I'm just so happy to own this. And yeah, looking at this though, like, I never saw City of Fallen Angels, like, right there, and it's so little, like the fourth book is so little compared to the rest. I never noticed that before, but yeah, I'm just digging this box set. And yeah, that was it for my Christmas book haul, and I'm a little overwhelmed by all the books, and I hope you all had a fantastic Christmas, and let me know below what your favorite Christmas present was, and I will see you soon with another video. Bye.